Cuba is the best. Cuba is so special compared to any other country that I have ever visited, and I fell totally in love with the classic cars, the salsa vibes, and the atmosphere.
But because of the embargo, the history, and the communism, Cuba is also really different from any other country. Because you can't just walk to a supermarket and buy basic stuff, or go on the internet at your hostel.
So, before going to Cuba, I think you should watch this video where I'll give you my best tips to what you should know, including how to get Wi-Fi, how you can avoid scams, what you should be considering if you're backpacking, how you can see the difference between the two currencies, how safe it is in Cuba, and some other topics. Let's begin. First and foremost, depending on your nationality, you'll probably have to apply for a visa to enter Cuba. So if you need a visa, you can just Google visa to Cuba and the website for applying will show up. In my case, since I'm Danish, I also needed to have a health insurance or I had to pay for one in Cuba. So make sure you know exactly what kind of documents you need to enter the country.
Tip number two is about which city you should visit it during your time.
Most travelers spend some days in Havana, which was actually my favorite city because I love the vibe, the many classic cars, and watching the sunset at the Malecon. Vinales, which is a huge green area, is also a popular place because this area is famous for the tobacco plantations and the beautiful Mangotes Mountains, and you can for example get on a tour on a horse for a day and visit a cigar plantation and so much more. I tried that and it was really a good experience. Another popular city in Cuba is Sanfuegos, which was built by French immigrants and is rich in its architectural style. For example, I have never been to a city with so many pillars. Only 1.5 hour drive away from Sanfuegos is the city Trinidad, which every traveler I met on my journey told me was the most beautiful city in Cuba. The old town is definitely a must-see because it is so different compared to Havana and Sanfuegos, so yeah, I also really think it should be something you prioritize to see during your time in Cuba. To me, Trinidad was the place to discover the true salsa atmosphere because the city is full of dance. Another thing I really liked about Trinidad was all the markets. A lot of travelers also go to the city Varadero. I didn't go there because I heard there's a lot of tourists, but if you want to go to the beach, you should consider going to Varadero. There's also many other famous and interesting cities in Cuba, but I only had 12 days, so I got the most out of Havana, Vinales, Sanfuegos, and Trinidad, and I've made separate videos about these cities with my best travel tips that you can watch afterwards if you want a more detailed description on what to do and see in these cities. Tip number three, where to stay. If you truly want to know and explore the Cuban culture, I would recommend that you book a room or an apartment or a house in the different cities. They are also called casa particulares. Unless you are a solo traveler, like I was, then I recommend both casa particulares and staying in hostels, because I met a lot of nice people and that made my journey even better. But the reason for staying at a casa particulares is that you can see a Cuban house from the inside, and they can really be a surprise because they don't look like much from the outside, but inside they can be quite impressive. Because with the high ceiling, the huge doors and windows, and sometimes pillars, the houses are really great. This one is from a Casa Particulares in Sanfuegos. I booked my Casa Particulares through Airbnb, but if you don't want to plan everything from the beginning, then you can also tell if a house is renting out rooms by this sign. This sign means that they have a permission from the government to rent out a room or the entire building, and since it is another way for the Cubans to earn money, the Cubans really make sure that everything is clean and nice, so you'll give them a good review. So you can feel totally safe about renting a Casa Particulares. I did not have any bad experience. I booked all my Casa Particulares from home, but if you're more adventurous than me, you can just ask a house with the sign for a room, and if they are filled, they will probably help you get another room at a friend or neighbor house. Because Cuban works in circles and help each other. also because they might get a commission by helping. But that is also one of the reasons why you should be cautious. For example, if somebody starts talking to you on the street and then they'll tell you that today there is a salsa festival or another kind of festival and they can show you where the festival takes place. But in reality, they'll just take you to a normal salsa class, which you of course have to pay for. There's nothing wrong with a salsa class. It is definitely something I enjoy doing my stay myself, but not when it's a scam and you have been told that there's a big salsa festival, which is just a lie. Twice somebody on the street told me there was this festival and I was just polite and said no thank you to join. There can also be some other scams, but in general, Cubans are really friendly people, so as long as you use your common sense, you'll be fine. One last tip is that if you're interested in buying cigars, you should avoid buying them on the street because they have a lower quality compared to the plantations or if you buy cigars at a real cigar shop. Tip number 4, how to go on the internet. If you want to go on the internet in Cuba, you have to buy a special card and use a code to log on. The card is sold at the Texas Telecommunications Center. The Texas Center are several places in Havana and is placed very central in smaller towns. You can just ask the Cubans for direction. Remember to bring some ID to buy the card. You can only connect some special places in the cities like parks, for example. The best way to tell if there's Wi-Fi is if a lot of people in a small place are standing together with their cell phones. To activate the card, you need to scratch the silver off, and the best way is with a Visa or another card and not a coin. I tried with a coin and it destroyed one of the numbers, so I couldn't tell what to write. Remember to log off the Wi-Fi once you're done, otherwise it will continue to take your time and you have to pay for a new card. Tip number 5, how to navigate in the city. Since the internet is limited, I will suggest that you get the app MapsMe. It is free and I used it anywhere I went because once you have downloaded the map over the city, you could use it even when you're offline. There's a marker that is tracking you so you know exactly where you are in the city, and the app works also like a GPS, so you can put in a place you want to go and it will tell you the direction. That made walking and discovering so much easier. You can also mark special places on the map and look at reviews from the restaurants in the city. I will recommend that you mark your hostel or casa particulares on the map because then you can show exactly where you want to go to a taxi driver who might not speak that much English. Tip number 6 is about money. When it comes to the currency, you should not bring American dollars to Cuba. Because of the embargo, it has a lower value and you'll get less money when you exchange them. I had no Cuban money when I went to Cuba, so I exchanged some euros in the airport. But I've been told by the Cubans that you can get a better and higher rate in the banks, so I exchanged the rest of my euros there. It is very important that you bring your passport to the bank, otherwise they can't exchange your money. There are two currencies in Cuba. The one is Cuban convertible peso, also called CUC, CUC. One CUC is around $1. This currency is used by tourists and is the strong and popular one because it has a bigger value. The second one is called Cuban peso nacional, also called CUP, CUP. CUP or moneda nacional is used by the local Cubans to pay and it has a lower value. One CUC is around 25 CUP. It is very important that you learn how to know the difference between the two currencies because I've heard that some tourists pay with CUC, the most value currency, but get CUP, the lower currency, back and loses thereby a lot of money. You can tell the difference between the two currencies if you look at the pictures. The strong currency, CUC, has buildings on the bills, whereas the lower currency, Moneda Nacional, has a person on the bills. There's also a difference with the coins. The strong currency has silver coins, and the lower coins also have silver and gold in them. Tip number 7. How to travel. There are different ways to travel in Cuba. You can take the bus, called Via Sul, a colectivo taxi, or the train. Traveling in Cuba cannot be compared to anything else I've tried. For example, I was actually planning to go to Santiago de Cuba, which is around 600 kilometers from Trinidad in the south. So without further investigation, I just thought that a bus could drive around 100 kilometers in an hour, and then it would take 6 hours to get there, plus some breaks in between. So around 8 hours in total. But I was so wrong. To go to San Diego de Cuba from Trinidad takes more than 12 hours. So you should really do some research in case you want to travel a lot. To avoid making this video too long, I have made another video about traveling in Cuba that I suggest that you watch afterwards. In that video, I'll dig into the ups and downs with the bus and the Colectivo taxi. When it comes to transportation in the cities, you should always agree on the price before getting into a taxi. And it can be a very good idea to have your address written down to show the taxi driver, because we did experience some drivers who did not speak English. You can also take the public bus, but if you are not with somebody that speaks Spanish, it might be a little bit difficult to know where to get off. The bus ticket is paid with the currency, moneda nacional, so a ticket is only around 5 cents, but you should also know that the buses can be quite crowded. Tip number 8. Learn some basic Spanish. I was a little bit surprised that some of the Cubans I met who worked with tourists every day did not speak English, like my guide in Vinales and some waiters at restaurants. To be fair, that also happened when I was in Mexico. But my point is that I really recommend you to know the most basic words in Spanish, like where's the restroom, because that phrase might come in handy. Tip number 9. How to get from the airport to Havana. Most people, when they arrive in Cuba, will stay in Havana. So if you're going to Havana, you should know that it should cost you around $25 to $30, which is like 25 to 30 kuk, to take a taxi from the airport to the capital. Getting to Havana City will take you around 30 minutes. Tip number 10 is about food. And I will be honest with you, Cuba is not yet a place to get the best food in the world. It is not a food paradise filled with temptations. But I did have some really good meals, like this gorgeous lobster in Trinidad, these fried rice in San Fuegos, and this ice cream that cost me less than 30 cents. And this is the peso ice cream, and it was really delicious. But anyway, compared to other countries, Cuba doesn't have the same variation and delicious recipes yet. But there's also another thing you should know about the food, and that is that you should definitely take diarrhea pills with you, because I had 2 diarrhea accidents, and the funny part was that it happened after I had ate spaghetti at 2 different restaurants. So just to make sure you also know that, bring some diarrhea pills with you. And I've made another video about what you should put in your suitcase in case you're going to Cuba, because it will be quite difficult to get it in Cuba. I've also made videos about each city, and in those videos I also give food tips to where you can get a really good meal. I have put the link in the end of this video. Tip number 11 is really useful if you want to drink alcohol, because you might want to try a Cuba Libre or the really good mojitos. But they might taste quite different compared to what you're used to, because the rum is cheaper in Cuba than the soda. So it might be quite strong. I had a mojito in Vinales and it was so strong that I couldn't even drink half of it, because otherwise I would have been wasted, and that would not have been a good idea when I was going to ride a horse afterwards. Tip number 12, safety. I can't make this video without talking about safety. Like I said, I was a solo traveler in Cuba and my hair is blonde. So there was a lot of men every day that said I was beautiful and wanted to talk to me and get my attention, but I did not experience anybody who made me feel uncomfortable. The Cuban men certainly liked my Scandinavian look, but never crossed the line. There's only this weird thing once where a guy approached me while I was sitting eating at a cafe and asked me if I wanted to make a baby with him. And no thanks. I talked to other girls in Cuba and some of them felt also approached but didn't mind, and others really thought it was uncomfortable. So I guess it also depends on how you feel about being talked to by strangers. But I just want to make it clear that I never felt afraid when I was traveling alone in Cuba. This is the end of my video. Thank you for watching. I hope you'll subscribe to get more free travel tips from my other journeys around the world. And if you click on this link, you can see my other videos about Cuba, where I visited Havana and saw the capital. Cienfuegos, which is a, it's not a French city, it was built by Frenchmen. Of course, it's a Cuban city, but it's so special because it is built by Frenchmen, so there's a lot of pillars and the only arch in Cuba. And then you can watch my video about Trinidad, which was a city everybody told me that you just need to go to. And I totally agree. Trinidad is so special, and it was the place where I actually learned to dance salsa. So I can really recommend this place as well. I wish you have a good day. Bye.